Welcome back! This is Alex S, and today we are going to build an Impulse RC Reverb for Simon. Simon got himself a brand new Tramp VTX, which is, I really like this. This works really well for me on my builds. XT60 for it. Brand spanking new RXSR receiver from FR Sky, which is really small. I really like this little receiver too. Brand new battery strap from Pyroflip. Thank you, Sergio. Pyro drone or Pyroflip rover anti-vibration stand-ups, which I also like a lot. This works really well with this particular build. Sunrise model all in one board, which I've been running and I've been having a really great success after figuring out the filters and how it really likes to run. So I'll be showing all that in this build as well. Brand new run cam mini, which I really like too. Heap of wire, and I think that is, oh, the biggest thing, here she is in the package, the Impulse RC Reverb. Okay, you guys, I'm still debating if I'm going to do a time lapse or just do it live. I'm going with the time lapse because it's raining and it's miserable outside and I cannot go out and fly. Anyways and anyhow, this is just an update. This is me telling you, you gotta go out and fly if it's not raining or snowing or I don't know what, but just go and fly. Thank you guys, I'll catch you in the next one. All right, so the first thing that I like to do is basically lay out the frame and just check out the quality of the carbon, make sure that I have everything that I need to build it. So in this case we're doing good, everything should be fine. I already built my prior reverb there, so all right, Simon, I guess that next step is going to be sanding it, because I do like to sand the frame before I start putting everything in there. So I'm gonna go outside, sand the frame, and I'm going to put the rivets inside also, which I have my own special tappity-tappity-tap way to do it. And at that point, once that's done, I'll put the frame all together and I'll catch you in a second. Okay, welcome back. This is test number 5. Oh my goodness gracious. Since yesterday, it's been raining, miserable outside, and then my SD card took a dump on me. And every time that I try to record something, it says SD card error, SD card error, SD card error. Okay, so rant's over. Hey Simon, good morning. Yesterday we set up the frame, we laid it out, took it outside, sanded in the rain, so now it's nice and chamfer. This is kind of like my only grief with this frame is that it's not chamfered. I would have liked to be chamfered for the same price or less, but come on, we gotta let them make some money, right? Because everybody deserves to make money. In reality, we need to accept that this hobby is also an industry. And I don't know one single person who does work for free 100%. If there's anybody out there who wants to do work for free, please let me know, because I don't know too many. Okay, you guys, so basically I have the capacitor right here. this is a OEM Panasonic 1000 microfarenheit 35 volt, which is the real deal. This is my board. This is a Sisking all-in-one that I really like and works really well on my builds. This is my tramp, and today we're gonna hook up the tramp to the board directly through the power leads from the BVAT. We're also going to install our XT60, and then we're gonna add also our harness for our receiver. The receiver is going to be FR Sky RXSR, and that is a catch up in a real less than 2 minutes because the camera might die, and I have a really tiny SD card in there. Oh my god, how frustrating. But yesterday I tried everything to reformat this thing. If somebody knows what's up with this, please let me know. I think it's just went bad, but it sucks. Okay, you guys, thank you very much. And thank you, Simon, for choosing me as your builder. We're gonna try to make this work. I stopped an old man along the way, hoping to find some old forgotten words or ancient melodies. Let's go! Alright, you guys, welcome back. This is Alex S, and today I want to show you the final product almost of Simon's Reverb. Simon came over this morning and we worked on installing the motors, doing all the shrink wrap stuff. We then soldered all the motors to its own terminals. Then he wanted, and he brought his own conformal coating, which was pretty, oh man, that thing stinks! But that's just the good part, and everybody will be wondering what's up with this blue stuff on the back. And that's basically just tape holding it for just position purposes. I am printing a really nice TPU mount for it, for the antenna, which hopefully the lollipops come through and we can run this with lollipop antennas, which I really want to try. After that, I had a whole debacle with the memory cards. Oh man, the last day or so, all my memory cards were not working. For some reason, this one will say SD card error. This is brand new. So I bought it on eBay, and look at the packaging. This is how it came. It was like all broken and open, and I'm like, come on, really? But as long as the card wasn't used, but when I turned the card around, it looked like it's being used. So I'm like, so you're sending stuff that is being used? Oh, I was so disappointed. Well, anyways, that was number one. Then I decided, hey, you know what? I'm gonna call GoPro, and GoPro said, no, just buy another card, it should be fine. So I go and buy another car at Best Buy. I jump in my BMW, and I hear an ocean of water sloshing and splashing inside. And I'm like, oh my god, what's going on now? And I love my 335, but damn, every week is something with that car. It just drives me nuts. So anyways, it drives really good. It is fast. But oh, so you know, I had this before when it really, really rains a lot. I think I have a plug on my sunroof, and that's what the water was coming. It's on my rear passenger side. If anybody knows what's up with that, please hit me up, because I'm kind of like trying to troubleshoot it right now. So I just spent the last 2 hours with a vacuum outside and with a fan outside trying to dry up the car. Then I have problems with the SD cards, and it's just been a headache of a day. But the good news is that this is almost over, and I'll be testing this tomorrow probably. And this is thumbs up. We're ready to go with Simon's Reverb. But the really good news is that the CGs are here. Rich from Hyperlow Frames actually shipped, and I have them, and I'm gonna start building them probably tonight or tomorrow morning. And that will be my next video when I unveil my CG, which I've been really saving to be able to put it together, because it was very expensive. All the components that I put in are really, really good. So I'm super stoked about it, and thank you so much to all the subscribers. I just checked it and it was 115 people And man, I cannot get enough of you guys watching these videos and sending me all the emails and the feedback. And thank you so much also to Steve. Hey Steve, I sent your quads back, I fixed them, and I hope you love them and enjoy them as much as I did. I want to show you some videos about that, and those are the 180 tilt rotors that are completely something else that I never tried before. Anyway, you guys, I'm not going to cut it short right now because I've probably been talking forever. If somebody's still watching this, thank you so much for listening, and have yourself a beautiful day. And this is Alex S. saying you gotta go flex some more.